What up, YouTube? It's your boy AQ, and I'm back with another reaction video for you guys today, man. And let me just say this, man. One thing I hate to see is men fighting over another woman. Make it even worse, I hate to see two men trying to delete each other over a woman, because a woman is always in the middle of that. And while y'all two killing each other, she's going to be smashing somebody else after y'all end up in jail or y'all end up dying. So today we're going to do a reaction. This video is a rapper killed by his friend for sleeping with his pregnant girlfriend in the apartment. Let's get into it.
And he pulled the shower curtain back like he was gonna get out of it. And this is when I just heard the gunshots going on.
This is the tragic story of a young man named Maurice Vaughn Jackson, age 26, also known as Little Nuke, a rapper who was shot inside his friend's girlfriend's apartment while he was having a good time with her. Quincy Wade, who was an on-and-off boyfriend of Chana Powell, was shocked when he found Maurice, his friend, with his girlfriend in an apartment he and Chana shared. Chana would later testify in support of Maurice in court, shocking her real boyfriend Quincy, thinking she would be loyal to him. This case will be taking us to Columbus, Georgia. Columbus is the second most populous city in Georgia after Atlanta, and fields the state's fourth largest metropolitan area. Columbus' rate of violent crime is well above the national average. Columbus is approaching 200 people shot this year. Maurice Vaughn Jackson, age 26, was a rapper out of Columbus, Georgia.
Inspiring the song for you to make the song.
Fuck with me hard, but yeah. It was just my folks in the streets and shit, so it was already like,
yeah.
Oh, that new.
Yeah.
It was already there.
So then, from that song itself, you already knew right then, all right, I'm gonna take this music serious, we about to go up with it.
Yeah, nah, I ain't gonna need a lot to you, bro. It wasn't even that, I just love music, period. Come from, like, where I'm coming from, I come from, like, everybody else, you know, probably been through the same situation, 10 niggas on one couch.
Yeah.
Sitting on one couch.
I was signed to basically load the record at first.
Word.
Yeah, by like 17, 18, you know, had a little situation going on, so.
Real.
On the other hand, one of his friends is named Quincy Wade. Quincy was dating a young lady named Chana Powell. Quincy and Chana were on and off boyfriends. They had a 7-year-old child together, but they were mostly going through a rough patch as a couple. Most of their friends knew about this, but for some reason Maurice might have not gotten the picture, so he eventually started dating Chana at a point where Quincy and Chana were having issues. During the most recent phase of their breakup, Quincy had been said to have sent threatening text messages where he claimed to know where she was and who she was with. He also followed her and would show up to her work and other places she hung out. On the day of this crime, Quincy again sent multiple texts to her before he went to the Patriot Place apartment where Chana lived. Quincy's name was still on the lease too. He somehow knew Chana and Maurice were in the house, so he tried to get in but could not, so he went round the apartment and got in through the sliding glass. There were some other people in the apartment, but when Chana and Maurice realized what was happening, they ran to hide in the bathroom, but Quincy found them and kicked the door open. Chana was able to escape while the two men opened fire on each other. Quincy was struck in both legs while Maurice was shot straight in the heart, lower arm, hip, and back areas. Quincy then fled the apartment and called a friend to pick him up. The two drove to a LaGrange hospital where the friend indicated that Quincy had been involved in a Columbus shooting, leading hospital staff to call authorities for assistance. Police arrived and saw all what had happened at the scene. When they interviewed Chana, she did not tell them that she had spoken to Quincy earlier during the day and had forgotten she invited Quincy to come over. She also did not tell them that she was 11 weeks pregnant for Quincy. She also never mentioned that Quincy had a gun to her head before the gunfire. She said he forced himself into the apartment. Quincy was held in jail as the case went to trial because he pleaded not guilty in the case. He claimed he was defending himself. He finally ended up in court and the trial started.
A suspect in the murder of a 26-year-old Maurice Von Jackson.
This right here is crazy. The fact that she was 11 weeks pregnant with this man child. She invited him over and forgot that she invited him over. That's kind of crazy. And make it even worse, she had another man over in an apartment that they are both sharing. So what that means, he's probably paying the rent and things like that because that's his baby mother. And she had another man in the crib. This right here is crazy.
Seeing Jackson. Here's what Powell testified happened moments before shots rang out.
Did Mr. Wade say anything at that point? What did he say? At that point, Maurice Jackson started out at the tub. He had a gun, and you will hear that he could legally own a gun. He had a gun, and he took it out. 16 shots were fired in that bathroom. We do not know who shot first.
The defense argued Powell never told this to police. Instead, she made up the statement of Wade threatening to shoot her.
When Ms. Powell was first interviewed and talked to about this incident, she didn't say nothing about Mr. Wade. Pulled the gun on her, put it to her stomach, put it to her head, say, I'm going to shoot you and the baby. That's all cap. That's all made up.
After the back and forth between the lawyers on both sides, it was now the time for jury to decide the fate of Quincy. They eventually sided with Quincy and found him not guilty of most of the charges.
A Columbus man accused of killing the boyfriend of his ex-girlfriend was acquitted on all felony charges this evening after a six-hour jury deliberation. Quincy Wade was accused of shooting to death Maurice Jackson, the new boyfriend of his on-again, off-again girlfriend, Shayna Powell. The jury found Wade not guilty of felony murder, malice murder, aggravated assault, and home invasion. The home invasion charge was reduced to a lesser charge of criminal trespassing. In September of 2021, Jackson was with Powell at her friend's apartment on Buena Vista Road when Wade entered an unlocked door after 2 a.m. The state accused Wade of pointing a gun at Powell. Jackson and Wade shot at each other. Jackson was hit 4 times and died. The defense claimed the shootout was self-defense. The prosecution said it was a domestic violence situation that turned deadly. Here are the attorney's reactions to the verdict.
We are disappointed in the verdict. When we go to trial, we believe we have the evidence to prove the case beyond a reasonable doubt, and so we are disappointed in the outcome.
Well, not necessarily surprised by the verdict. We knew we had good arguments, and we knew we were able to come in and make our case. I never, ever call a verdict before, so I never think it's going to go either way. Old attorney taught me that once you're going to trial, you think about the ways that you can win it, not about the ways that you can lose it, but you always know that it's a gamble.
Wade was found guilty of criminal trespassing. This charge is a misdemeanor and has a maximum sentence of 12 months. Wade has been in jail for about 2 years. There's no word on when he will be.
Fellas, sleeping with your friend, girlfriend, while she's pregnant, that will get you killed, brother. And here's the thing. Going over to another man's girl crib, that will also get you killed. And it will also be a free kill based on self-defense. As men, we have to be wise, bro. Don't let these women put y'all in these funny, weird situations. If you know a woman is dealing with another dude, don't go over to her place, bro. Especially if it's your friend. Leave that alone. This right here is wow.
And this woman is consistent with a gunshot wound.
Yes.
I spoke with Maurice Jackson, the victim's father. He says after seeing the evidence of what happened the night of the murder, one thing remains the same for him.
It's not about who shot first. It's a case about one thing when my son lost his life, protected himself and who he was with that night. When trouble came knocking on their door, they place to stay where they was, mind their business. It's all the case is about.
Quincy Wade is facing multiple charges of malice and felony murder, in addition to aggravated assault and home invasion. The victim's father says he is hopeful his son will get justice.
At the end of the day, justice is going to be served for Maurice. And justice is going to be served for all the times he did her the way he did her. She's just too scared to come for her. At the end of the day, but it's all out now. But at the end of the day, Maurice is going to get justice.
During the trial, the lady in question, Chana Powell, who a lot of people blamed for all this, was put to the stand and cross-examined by the defense.
Testimony began this morning in the trial of a man accused of murdering his ex-girlfriend's new boyfriend in September of 2021. Jurors are not tasked with deciding whether the defendant shot the victim. Rather, was it done in self-defense? WRBL's Hannah James was in court and files this report.
On September 7th, of 2021 at approximately 2:30 a.m., Quincy Wade shot and killed Maurice Vaughn Jackson. That will not be in dispute in this case.
Testimony shows Wade entered the residence his ex-girlfriend, Chana Powell, was staying in uninvited. Wade then kicked in the bathroom door both Powell and Jackson were hiding in.
The evidence is going to show that as they're having this conversation in the bathroom, Mr. Wade is facing towards where Mrs. Powell is, which is kind of in an area behind the bathroom door, across from the bathroom mirror, and they have this conversation. All right? And at that point, Mr. Wade is shot twice by Mr. Jackson, who comes out of the shower curtain. Unbeknownst to Mr. Wade, doesn't even know he's there. And shoots him twice. Alright? And in response to that, Mr. Wade fires rounds to defend himself.
In a way, this case is about self-defense, but it's about Maurice Vaughn Jackson defending himself and Chana.
Testimony painted a picture of years worth of domestic disputes and violence between Wade and Powell. At the time of the shooting, Powell was pregnant with Wade's child. However, she was...
This right here is sad, bro. Fellas, I keep telling y'all, bro, keep away from women with this type of energy, bro. Because when you really think about it, fam, she's in the middle of all of this. She's the reason why those two dudes clash. She had his friend over, and by no means you shouldn't be messing with your homie friend. But she had his friend over, and she also invited her baby father over at the same time. And apparently they were arguing before he actually got over there. And he was hiding in the bathroom. And the dude who got killed shot the other dude twice in the leg while she was right next to him. So he was hiding with her in the bathroom, and that transpired. And the other dude defended himself, and he ended up killing her side dude. This right here is crazy.
Seeing Jackson, here's what Powell testified happened moments before shots rang out.
Did Mr. Wade say anything at that point? What did he say? At that point, Maurice Jackson started out of the tub. He had a gun, and you will hear that he could legally own a gun. He had a gun, and he took it out. 16 shots were fired in that bathroom. We do not know who shot first.
The defense argued Powell never told this to police. Instead, she made up the statement of Wade threatening to shoot her.
When Ms. Powell was first interviewed and talked to about this incident, she didn't say nothing about Mr. Wade. Pulled the gun on her, put it to her stomach, put it to her head, say, I'm going to shoot you and the baby. That's all cap. That's all made up.
After the back and forth between the lawyers on both sides, it was now the time for jury to decide the fate of Quincy. They eventually sided with Quincy and found him not guilty of most of the charges.
A Columbus man accused of killing the boyfriend of his ex-girlfriend was acquitted on all felony charges this evening after a six-hour jury deliberation. Quincy Wade was accused of shooting to death Maurice Jackson, the new boyfriend of his on-again, off-again girlfriend, Shayna Powell. The jury found Wade not guilty of felony murder, malice murder, aggravated assault, and home invasion. The home invasion charge was reduced to a lesser charge of criminal trespassing. In September of 2021, Jackson was with Powell at her friend's apartment on Buena Vista Road when Wade entered an unlocked door after 2 in the morning. The state accused Wade of pointing a gun at Powell. Jackson and Wade shot at each other. Jackson was hit 4 times and died. The defense claimed the shootout was self-defense. The prosecution said it was a domestic violence situation that turned deadly. Here are the attorney's reactions to the verdict.
We are disappointed in the verdict. When we go to trial, we believe we have the evidence to prove the case beyond a reasonable doubt, and so we are disappointed in the outcome.
Well, not necessarily surprised by the verdict. We knew we had good arguments and we knew we were able to come in and make our case. I never ever call a verdict before, so I never think it's gonna go either way. Old attorney taught me that once you're going to trial, you think about the ways that you can win it, not about the ways that you can lose it, but you always know that it's a gamble.
Wade was found guilty of criminal trespassing. This charge is a misdemeanor and has a maximum sentence of 12 months. Wade has been in jail for about 2 years. There's no word on when he will be.
In the words of the lawyer, that's all cap. Look, this chick is understand, and she's forcing to cry while no tears is coming out of her eyes. You think this woman is sorry for what she did? In her eyes, she probably didn't do anything. And this is why I urge you dudes to keep away from these low-hanging fruits, man. Keep away from these low-vibrational women. These women have a very dark energy in them, fam. They will get you killed. They will have you in jail trying to defend them while they simply going to move on and smash another dude or find another victim. By no means as a man you should be messing with your boy girl, especially while she's pregnant. But I also believe she also led that man on and brought him to that apartment. And she also invited her baby father. I believe she probably pinned those two dudes against each other. And that's what transpired. One dude died. The other dude got shot. And he was able to beat the case on self-defense. Fellas, be wise out here, bro. And be careful when it comes to these types of women, bro. This right here is sad. Please leave your thoughts in the comments. I'm out.